people with the spirit of forget, welcome back to my video in YouTube. My name is Angga, and a lot of people were asking to me how did I learn Android programming. So that's why I have been answered that question in the previous video. So you might want to watch, just click here. And in this video, okay, what's Angga? So basically in this video we're gonna learn the Android programming to make the Android game, which is puzzle. So the user have to combine the letters one by one and to become one sentences, like animal, maybe bird, panda, cat or dog. Well, basically I have been designing with the sketch, and we're gonna implement that design to the Android Studio, and I have provided the assets. Wait a minute. This little girl is always disturbing me. Okay, so you have to download those assets first in the video's description, and after that we're gonna learn together. Okay, so let's get started.
Okay, everyone with the spirit of learning, welcome to my desktop, and this is the design that I have been designing for you. And you don't have to be worried because I already prepared all of those assets, so you are able to download in the video's description. Oh, I think I forgot one. This is our boss. We can't forget our boss. How can? Okay. And then I already create the Android Studio project. So basically, at the first step, we have to focus on the layout first. We don't have to think about the Java. Okay, so I'm going to the styles. I'm going to remove the action bar, okay. And then after that, I'm going back to the sketch to see the gradient. You know, this is the hex code of the gradient. So this is for the first color. So we have to build our background into a drawable. So basically, this is supposed to be background app, okay. And in the selector, you have to replace by shape. Okay. This one. Okay. So first is a gradient color, gradient, and then for the start color, supposed to be the one that I copy, and then for the secondary color, copy, end color, like this, and setting the angle, and cool, it's working. So in this case, I prefer like to use the linear layout, okay, and setting the orientation to be a vertical with the background is a background app, okay. And then I'm going back to the background app to get this hex code, you know, the first color, and I'm going back to the styles, oh sorry, to the colors. So there's the color primary dark that you have to replace for the status bar. So for the status bar later on, it's supposed to be like this. It's same color, you know, cool. And for this hello world, I think I will remove this, and I change it to the invite battle. Okay. And the text size supposed to be 22 SB. And then text color supposed to be white color, and then we use the graffiti center. Oh, I think it's supposed to be layout graffiti. Okay, cool. And if you see the design, the font type is different because I have been customized the font type. And there's the margin, which is 40 pixels. So we have to setting the margin top to the 40 pixel or DP. Okay. And don't forget to give the ID, because this ID is used to customize the font type. So, you know, I think this is supposed to be text screen. Okay, because each screen has different text, you know. And we have the question here, so I think I'm going with the linear layout here. So we see first, so it's about 290 and 150, I think. 290 and 150. Okay. And then I have to setting the orientation, maybe just vertical. And inside of the linear layout, we have like, you know, a text view. But this is supposed to be a text question. Okay. And for the text question, we have to setting it to be, you know, another text. So this one, we have to remove. And going back to the sketch, you're gonna see the real sentences. So like this, okay. And we have to text setting the text element to become a center, right? Cool. And for the layout width, I'm going to setting maybe 140 dp, but I have to change to the bigger screen first. No, I think 200. Yeah, it's cool. And line spacing extra supposed to be 6 dp. Okay, nice. And later on we're gonna customize the font type, so you don't have to be worried. Okay, and I'm going back to the sets. I'm going to copy all of them to our drawable over here, which is a drawable. Okay. And then in the linear layout here, over here, we have to set in the background, which is background question. Okay. And I have to go back to the sketch because I have different color, you know, over here. So I think I have to replace this text view with this one. Yeah. And then for the linear layout, we see that they got the margin top 50. So I think that I have to set in first the gravity to the center, and then setting the margin top to the 50. Yeah, that's nice. And the font type hasn't changed yet because we haven't updated yet in the Java. Okay, what's next? So after the question, we have to setting the answer, we are going to use edit text here. So for the width, we have to setting 200 dp, and then height 80 dp, and we have to setting the background, which is the answer. Background purple. Okay, that one, cool. And then we have to setting the margin top 70 dp, and then we have to setting layout gravity center. Okay, and then we have to setting the gravity center for the text, and text size about 22 sp, and then text color, so we have to give the same color like we did in this. Okay, and then we have to give the focus able is false because we don't want to focus at that edit text, and clickable false, and then we have to give the padding 10 dp. Okay, so if you see the text just right here, maybe birth, you know. So it's gonna be like this, right? Cool. So we have to remove first because later on we're gonna use a Java to customize that font based on user's click event. Okay. And after that, we need the text view for the button. Why we don't use button? Yeah, you can use button, you can use edit text, you can use text view, it doesn't matter. But the main important thing is just a text view, you know. So this is the text view that we're gonna use. We use match parent and then wrap content, and then give the ID. Yeah, don't forget to give the ID. This is supposed to be layout parent, and this one supposed to be edit text. Okay, and then you have to give, like, you know, margin left and margin right, because this parent is the parent has width, which is match parent. So I think I have to setting the margin right 28 dp and margin left maybe we can go with 24, or it's supposed to be 28 dp. Oh sorry, this is not layout parent. Later on we're gonna use linear layout to make it more consistently. So I think this is for the title only, you know. If you see this design, there's the title, a basic title, it's not here. So for those buttons, we're gonna use linear layout to make it more consistent and usable. Okay, so we're going to the so we could use a text title, you know, and then we have to give the text here, which is emo. Emo is like in the game. And then text size we have to setting about 24 sp, and then after that text color, and then we have to give, you know, the width one I think supposed to be over there. Okay, it's enough. And yeah, don't forget to give the margin top actually, but you know, I think we supposed to setting from this 60. Okay, so you're going to the edit text and give them the margin bottom 60 dp. Alright, cool. And then after that we can go straight to prepare the button with the linear layout. So for the width we have to go with the match parent, and then this is wrap content. And for the horizontal, sorry, for the orientation we go with the horizontal, and the ID is supposed to be layout parent. Give the margin left 24 dp, give the margin right 24 dp. Okay, cool. So you couldn't see anything at these buttons because we are going to use, we're going to make it by a Java and use a Java to duplicate the button. Okay, so over here I will give the margin button first about 60 dp, 16. Okay, so this is our current design. If you see, the font type hasn't changed yet, and if you click the edit text, yeah, you see you're not able to write anything because we setting up like that. So we just need to click the button over here and it goes straight to this edit text. Cool, right? Now it's time to go to Java. Okay, so I think we have to go to Java in over here main activity. Okay, so first of all I have to setting the preferred ENT for integer, which is press counter. Okay, and supposed to be 0, and we have another press counter here. So basically we have to give 4. Why? Because birth is has a 4 character, you know. So we have to give preferred string, and then after that we have is a keys here, and it's like, you know, an array. So this is supposed to be R, and then supposed to be I, and then supposed to be B, and then supposed to be D. It's like B I R D birth, but we have to add something here that makes the user confused. Okay, and then after that we have to give the actual answer, So basically this is supposed to be string, and then we give them the answer. So the answer supposed to be bird, okay, because this is the animal, you know. Sorry, we don't have to use this. Yeah, just like this, because we don't use the array, you know. And then we have to register another text field for the font type. A text question. What was that? If we check over here, supposed to be text screen. And then for the customized font, a text question. And then this one, text title. Okay, cool. Okay, and then we need over here animation. Maybe we can use it later. So basically, after we declare the private variable, we have to give over here, which is key, and we have to create the shuffle array later on. This is we're going to shuffling those characters, so just makes user feel confused when they are using our game, you know. And then here we are going to use for string k is a keys, okay, it's a keys, and we have to give the function again, which is add view. Later on we're gonna make it. And then here we're going to use the linear layout, because previously we were using the linear layout, right? And we have to give R ID, which is layout parent. You remember that? And then over here we give key, and then it's supposed to be edit text, which is fine. Sorry, we have to put here edit text, fine RID and edit text. Okay, that's cool, right? And then after that we have to give like max press counter is 4, BIRD is 4 character. Okay, and now it's time to give you know, another private here. So this is supposed to be our shuffle array, so we're gonna shuffling the character later on with this function. Okay, shuffle array, and then string, and we give AR, which is array. And then after that we have to setting here, which is with the random, and then new random, because we want to randomly and just make the user feel like, whoa, what is this? Oh, we don't know. So they have take time to understand, to find the correct answer, you know. And we negative by 1, so we're going to use the looping. And I 0, and then I minus minus. Okay, and then like this. So here we're going to use index, and we have to use rind. We're going to the next integer, you know, or with the e plus 1. Okay, and then string A is R index, and R index supposed to be R integer. Okay, and then R integer supposed to be A. Okay, so we already have the shuffle array over here. Cool, and we just need to make the function that allow us to displaying the buttons in the layout, which is add view, okay? And after that, we have to return error. Okay, cool. Okay. Okay, so for the next one, we have to make this a function, you know? So I think we have to create the method for this one, but I think it's not supposed to be like this, right? So I think we have to make it after this shuffle, you know. So just private void and add view, okay, and then linear layout, which is a view parent, and final string text and final edit text, okay. So basically this add view, it's gonna be clickable, and we're gonna give the value to validate later on. We will have the validation, and after that is a linear layout is layout param. Okay, and then linear layout param. New linear layout param, okay, and then over here we have to setting by linear layout layout params, which is a raw content, okay, and after that linear layout layout params raw content. So there's two parameter, you know. So basically for the width and for the height, okay. And then after that, we have to setting another margin here for the margin. So it's supposed to be like this, and then right margin supposed to be 20, because if you see in the design, you see this is 20 and 20, right? So I think we just need to setting the margin 20, okay, the margin right, okay. And after that I have to setting the final text view here for the button text view, then new text view, and then here supposed to be this, okay. And then after that we have to making up the text view. And I think I miss one again here, okay, yeah, like this. And then I miss something again here, another clause like this, okay, nice. And we could continue to the making up the text view. So for the text view, we have to setting the set layout params. And then over here we supposed to be linear layout params, okay. And another text view we have to setting set the background, okay, and supposed to be get resource, and then get drawable, and then this is supposed to be r drawable and background pink, okay, cool. And then after that I have to setting, sorry, we have to setting the set text color, okay, and this is supposed to be, oh sorry, this is supposed to be dot this, and then get resource again, and this is supposed to be get color, which is r color. But we don't have the color yet, so I think we have to register this color over here, okay. So we give the name maybe color white, or we can use another color which is a purple, you know, because the background is already white, so I think that we have to go to background app. We have to go to the design and get this one, copy, and then after that I have to put here color purple. Okay, and this is supposed to be color purple. Okay, and then after that text view set gravity to become a gravity center. Okay, and then text view supposed to be set text. Okay, and then another one is for the clickable. Yes, of course, text view set clickable true. Okay, and another one we have to set focusable true. Okay, and then we have another text view which is a set text size 32. Okay, cool. So after that I have to customize the font face with the font that we have. Okay, but you have to create your own asset in the Android directory. So in the assets folder I prepare already for you, and then we have to go to the Android project, you know. So basically the name is what matters, and we have to go to app and then src and main, and if you see the assets. Okay, and then in assets we have to create another folder which is fonts. Okay, and then we paste over there. Okay, cool. So you see there's a font. Okay, and we just need to typeface and then typeface we create from the assets and get asset, and then after that we setting fonts and Fedora 1 regular TTF. Okay, and I see that there's a dust, so that's why we have to refactor to the rename and then just refactor. Okay, cool, like this. And after that we just need to give the value over here, but you know that we have to give the ID first. So basically like this, text view and then find RID text question. Okay, so we got 3 and we got what else, text screen and text title, text screen, and then we got text title. Okay, for the text screen like this, and this is for the text title. Okay, and after that it's gonna be much easier for us, just passing the set typeface which is typeface. Okay, and then we copy and then we copy like this. Okay, and if you wanna see the result, yeah, you can start into the emulator. So you see that the font type has different, but for the question, I think for the question, yeah, this is the text question, I think it's gonna make it bigger, you know. Okay, and then this is supposed to be like this. Okay, cool. And why I need this? Oh, so I think we have to use a gravity center. Okay, oh, it doesn't working. And then layout gravity center. Oh, I think I suppose to give this over here a gravity center. Okay, it's working, and we could see again, and I think it just too big. So I think I have to go with the smaller one, just with the 26. Okay, and we're going to continue to here. So here we have to give the function to let the text view be clickable, you know. But first of all, I have to give the edit text set. So this is for the our text view later on. Text view set type of s. Okay. And then here we have to set the on click listener like this. Okay. So how do we calculate how many user has been clicked? So we are going to use if press counter minus by max press counter, and then user still able to click. Okay, but if press counter equal to the zero, then edit text supposed to be set text. Okay, like this, because there's no character in the edit text that has been clicked, you know. And then after that, we have to give here, which is edit text set text, and then edit text get text to string. We have to generate we have to convert to the string with the text. Okay, and after that, text view start animation, but we don't have the animation yet, but it's okay, just big small font. I'm going to give the comment first, but we're gonna use it later on. Okay, and text view animate alpha 0 and set duration 300. Okay, and the press counter plus plus. Okay, and after that we give another validation here, which is if press counter equal to the max press counter, then we have to validate, do validate, but we haven't created yet this function. Okay, and then after that, after here, we have to give like view parent add view text view. Okay, and this function we don't have yet, so we can give the comment first. Okay, and if you wanna see the button, just play the emulator and tada, it's just nice, right? And I think it's so closer, huh? So you have to setting the margin to be 30. So this one nice, right? You are able to click all of them, but there's a problem. I couldn't click more than one button. Why? Let's find out the reason. Okay, to see what was happened, I just remove this one, remove, and then I let this validate like this. Okay, I think we need something here. Wait. Okay, so basically this is for this one, and this is for this one, and this is for the on click listener. Sorry, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, so for this one, we don't have to give the brackets anymore, so just go straight to the do validate. But we have to create our do validate, you know. So I think here I supposed to private void and then do validate. Okay, And we have to give the press counter to be a zero back to the normal. And we give the edit text, and find RID, which is edit text. Okay. And then we give the linear layout, and then linear layout find RID layout parent. Okay. And after that, let me give the negative space. Okay. And after that, we have to give the validation here, which is if edit text get text to string, and then equals to the answer, and then we have to go to another screen, right? But if else, sorry, here we have to give the edit text first, which is set text to be a reset. We're gonna reset them, but else like this, okay? And then after that, we have to register case shuffle array, and then keys, okay? And then linear layout remove all view, okay? And then after that, we have to back normal again. String k case, and then here at view is the linear layout k edit text. Okay, so let's try first. So we click here, and yeah, I don't know what was happened. So actually we are able to click all of them, right? So I think I have to figure out now. Okay everyone, so I missed something here. So basically previously we were using like this, right? And then you have to remove this bracket over here. So we just have one, two, and three. And the rest for this one we don't have to use a bracket, right? So that's the problem, just a little. And here, if the answer was correct, so we have to give the toast first, just make sure everything is okay. Main activity, this, and then correct, okay? And then toast, length sort, and so, okay? We copy. And then wrong, okay. After that we test into the emulator. Okay, so this is the user interface, and I have click like this wrong. Okay, so we have this I almost forget word correct. Okay, so if the answer were correct, it goes straight to the another activity, which is complete. Alright, so basically if you see the design, there's another activity over here, you see that? Yeah, so it's gonna be like this. Okay, so we have to prepare this activity. Okay, so what we're gonna do is going to the Java, and then over here I'm going to make another activity, new activity, which is empty activity. Okay, this is maybe boss egg. Okay, finish. All right, so it's still Gradle. And after that, I just go to back to the activity main and copy all of them and go to activity boss and just like this. Okay, but in this case we don't need the question. We have to remove, and we don't need all of them. What we need, it's only one, this one, in fact battle. So we have to change checkpoint time, okay? And if you see back the design, there's another text field for this one, but after the image field. So we have to provide the image field first, which is a wrap content, and then wrap content. And then we give src, which is boss, okay? And we have to give the margin top about 50 dp. And then we have to setting the gravity to the center. Okay, cool. Like this. And I have to copy this text field for this one. Well done. Ready for boss? Yeah, of course. This is text. Maybe we could give like text a question. It's okay. And then I have to give like this, you know, and setting the text element to be the center. And then I have to setting the layout width 200 dp. I think it's supposed to be this is supposed to be bigger, which is 28. Okay. And this is supposed to be smaller. No, I was expecting that. Ah, this one. Okay, cool. And then we have button here and one button here. So I have to start with the button first. Button. And for the width and height, supposed to be 290 with 70. Okay, and the background, background button. Okay, and then I think that's supposed to be 20. Yeah, cool. And then for the text size, if we see here, it's about 20 with the color purple, okay? So text SP, and the text is continue, and the text color purple, okay? And I have to give the all caps false, okay? And then later on, we have to give ID text title like this. So it will give the customized font later on. Okay. And then I have to put here a margin top 70 dp. I think it's supposed to be 90. Yeah. 100. Okay. And then I have to setting to the center like this. Okay, cool. And after that, I have to copy this text field after the button. I think I prefer like to go with this one, the text screen. Okay, just copy. And then I'm going to change this one to back to home. Yeah, like that. And this is supposed to be text button. Okay. And then I think I have to give the margin top about 20. Yeah. Sorry, maybe 30. Okay, cool. Yeah. So after this, we have to, sorry, for the button I will decrease by 80. Okay, so after this, we have to register this text button and a text question and anything, because we have to give them the special font type, you know, the typeface. So what we're gonna do is going back to the main activity and copy this text field, and then after that we have to add another text, which is a text button. Okay, and going back to the main activity, and we have to copy all of them to put here. Okay, like this. And we need another option for the text button, right? Okay, cool. Okay, so in the main activity, after the user is correct the answer, we have to go straight with the intern. Intern A, new intern, main activity, this, and then after that boss activity class. Okay, oh, we have to import the intern, yeah, like this. And then start activity, A. Okay, so I have to give the negative space like this. Okay, so we make one to try it. So first I have to answer with randomly, and then birth. Okay, it's nice, right? But what if we just need to make it more better? I mean, this one is not really looks nice, right? So I have to go to activity, and for the boss one, I think I'm supposed to make it like this, and then after that I have to give the image fill the margin top is about a 70. Okay, and for the button I will decrease by 60. Okay, and after that we can try again. So this is the design, BIRD. Yay, it's correct. Okay, so if you continue, it goes to the another activity, but if you back to home, it stay to the home. And I think back to home color supposed to be different, so I got this one, and go to Android, we have to fix it, just make it perfect, you know. Okay, and with, and for the continue, I don't think we have to give the padding button, maybe 10 dp. yeah, cool. And then play again. So this is the question, and then birth. Okay, looks nice, right? So yeah, that's all from me, and thank you very much. And we try again, once again. Wrong. Okay, we use bird. Yay, it's cool, right? And sorry, I remember that we have to play with the animation, right? So I think that we'll go to Aries to create new Android directory, which is anim. And then in the anim, we have to give like a small big fort. Okay, and I think that I will use scale from y, and then sorry, from 1, and this is from 1, and this is maybe about like this, and this is about like this, and duration 400. And then after that we have to setting the pivot 50% and pivot 50%, and give the duration as ready. And I think that over here we have to give the interpolator, which is Android, and then anim, maybe we can go SCC, which is accelerate, you know, this one. Okay, so we got this one, and we back to the main activity to register the animation, a small big fort. Okay, and over here we have to load the animation. Animation utils, load animation. This are anim small big font. Okay, and after we click the button, we have to give the small big font. Okay, and then we try into the emulator. So if you click the button, you see it goes to the small, you see, yeah, right. And I think for this one, sorry, I have to remove this one for the correct, so it just goes to the intent. And then for the boss, what about if we give the animation for the boss? Okay, so I think that we can use from this, just copy. And then what I'm gonna do, just go to anim to create another animation, small to big. Okay, and then so this one from the 0.0 0.0 to become 1 and 1.0. okay, and after that I have to remove, I have to close first, and we go to image view. And I think that I want to make it more bigger, you know, from the base of design. So this is about 100, so I have to setting DP. Boss is big, big boss. Okay, and don't forget to give the ID, which is big boss. Okay, we go to here with the image view, big boss. Okay, and after that we have to register this big boss image view. And then after that we have to give the animation here. So I think I just want to give animation and then small to big. Okay, and then small to big is animation utils, load animation. This are anim small to big. Okay, and after that we just need to passing this big boss start animation, maybe, oh sorry, small to big. Okay, before we play to the emulator, I have to go back to here to give the Android start offset, maybe after 300 milliseconds, then the animation will be appear. So we try. So first this is the animation like this, and then yeah, it's cool, right? But if you want to make for those buttons, you know, you can exactly just follow the last steps for this button, maybe from the bottom to the top. You can watch my another tutorial about the animation, so just check in the video's description. There's a lot of tutorial of Android animation, so you could use in this app. Okay, so we try again. Okay, cool, right? So thank you.
Okay everyone, thank you very much for watching, and I hope it was useful for you. Please let me know if you are still confused so we can learn together, and I am going to answer your question in the video's description. Sorry, in the video's comment. Alright, so nice to meet you from Indonesia. Don't forget to like, comment, and share with your friends. So, see you the next time. Goodbye.